Big week for the Dolphins. San Diego is in town. Look, oh, your boys Joe Philbin and Ryan Tannehill, 19-20 record. Yeah, your boys.
Why they gotta be my boys?
You know how you love them. 19-20 record. They can get to 500 this week, or else 19-21. You gotta wait another 2 weeks. And Mike Wallace, is he really upset? Chris Perkins, Omar Kelly of SunSentinel.com. Oh, we'll talk about Tannehill and Philbin and their 19-20 record in a second. They can get to 500. That's big news.
When they get to over 500, call me.
That might not happen this year. Listen.
Or ever.
See, why you want to do that? Mike Wallace. What is the yesterday? It appeared that he was not happy with the offense. What is the?
Is that a shock? Is that a surprise?
He was targeted seven times.
He was targeted seven times
in the Jacksonville game.
Caught one pass for 50 yards. How many of those targets were accurately thrown?
Well, not many.
Or on the mark?
Not many.
Or close?
Not many.
Okay, see, now we're getting to the root of the problem.
All right.
Now we're getting to the root of the problem. And, you know, even Joe Philbin said he didn't say anything that we as coaches haven't said for the past month.
Yeah.
I mean, they are one of the worst passing offenses in the NFL.
Right, right.
Well, I mean,
no surprise. Right? Next story.
The problem is, it's not just the quarterback. It's a lot of him.
Correct.
But it's not just the quarterback.
I firmly believe that. I don't believe in dumping on Philbin and Tannehill. I think this is a team wide.
Yes.
Right.
I mean, if Brian Hartline catches two of the passes that he was thrown.
Right.
Ryan Tannehill would have been a little bit better. If Darren College picks up two of the blocks, he killed three drives himself.
One
man killed three drives.
But he was debilitated, though. And again, College has been solid this year.
He has been solid this year, and he owned up to it. I love that. Respect it.
Right.
Now the question is, we get on the field. Are you comfortable with Dallas Thomas as a starting left guard?
No.
Why not?
Because he's too new. Now, here's the thing. Look,
he started three games. He's played 50 snaps last week.
Yep.
And was he a problem? Is he allowing the sacks? Is he the turnstile?
No.
Aren't they still running the ball?
They are. But look, I talked to Dallas after the game against Jacksonville, and he was really good, as he always has been. We've talked to him. And he was saying, and I said, you know, man, left guard? And he was like, yeah, I've been at right guard. I've been at right tackle, now at left guard. At some point, you reach that line of demarcation. It's too much. And so now this guy, second-year player, he's in his third position in
He's at his natural position. He was a college left guard.
Yes.
He played that at Tennessee. Allow the man to settle in. And I'm not saying that he should replace Darren College, but College hasn't been cleared to play it.
Right. We're saying this week. I would feel better with College. I guess I could trust Dallas Thomas. As far as the offense, you know, and one of the things that I talked about today that I asked them, halftime adjustments, do you give the coaching staff any credit? Oh, we know about the slow starts. Yeah, they average 11 points per third quarter. They're the highest scoring third quarter team in the NFL.
75 points that you've got to give them credit. If last year we were criticizing them because they didn't make halftime adjustments,
exactly.
They came out flat in so many games, you got to give them credit because they're actually doing it. The problem is, how do you translate that into faster starts?
Right.
I've often seen coaches do more competitive periods earlier in practice that sort of get your competitive juices flowing, running, going a little bit earlier, and I think that would benefit this team.
All right, that leads us into San Diego this week's game.
Good game, good matchups, tough challenge. Phillip Rivers on his worst day, he's as good as Ryan Tannehill is on an average day. So that just shows you the challenge that they have. I think it's got to be on the defensive line.
Yes.
They got to get him out of rhythm. Phillip Rivers, he's got that quick release like Dan Marino. It's gone. But if you make him move a little bit left and make him move a little bit right, his passes drop in terms of accuracy. Now he's nearly completing 70% of his passes.
Right.
So drop is still like 65%.
Right.
But you gotta contain the tight end, Antonio Gates. But I think this is a team that the Dolphins can run on. I know you're not big on that running game, even though they're averaging 138 yards per game. But this is a team the Dolphins can run on.
Yeah, I'm not big on the running game, I'll admit. I'm not big on the pass protection either. I'll admit that.
Okay.
But the defense, you're right on the mark with that. Look, and we know that this defensive line, that the way that they played against Aaron Rodgers, they'd have beaten any other quarterback in the NFL. It just so happens Aaron Rodgers is at his best when he's on the run. I think they harassed Phillip Rivers. I'm taking Dolphins 24-20.
You are shocking me.
I'm taking Dolphins.
And I'm going to surprise you because I'm actually picking Dolphins 21-17.
Joe
either look like geniuses or idiots.
Joe Philbin will preserve this, won't he? Actually, you'll probably never see it. For SunSentinel.com, Chris Perkins and Omar Kelly.